Let's see if I can get this party started. How is it going, everybody? Welcome to the Saturday night stream here on Buffalo Pinball. I'm your Saturday night host, McSirTuna, bringing you a tech stream tonight. That's kind of a tech stream, but not completely tech-ish. So it's an amalgam stream, software stream. We'll do software stream. Anyway, so those who may not know, there is a program out there called Pinball Browser. And that's what you're looking at right here in this window. Actually, there we go. This window here. And you kind of, I don't even honestly know exactly where you can get it directly. You can get it, as far as I know, from Pinside. I picked it up a while ago. I do have a... Get out of here with that. I do have... the one we're looking at right now is version 6.00. I believe there is a newer version available. I try to get it and it doesn't let me. So... none of that's really important. All you need to know is Pinball Browser is available somewhere. I would say go to Pinside in order to find out exactly where to download it. And if you do some searches on it, you would probably find it that way. And more or less what it lets you do is it lets you open up Stern Pinball Machine code and take a look deeper into the information. So here's what we're going to do. I'm going to demonstrate what it looks like. We're going to go ahead and click the open button. And the only thing is right now, I may have to do a little bit of fidgeting in order to make some of the visuals show up, since it does pop open windows, separate windows, and I'm doing a window capture. That being said, since I'm completely and obviously know exactly what I'm doing here. But anyway, so right now I hit open and it pops up a regular open window. And what you'll want to do is go ahead and go to a saved version of your Stern pinball code. And right now, today, we're going to take a look at The Walking Dead. Now, for the sake of, to start off here, what we're going to do is we're going to open up the 1.5 or 1.56 code, which is not the latest code, and I'll show you why we're doing that first. So once you hit open on that, it's going to go ahead and load up the code. And we're going to start by just doing a run through of what's available on here. And then we will go ahead and start diving into why I have this and what I've done with it. There is a whole lot more that you can do with this than what I've done. Yeah, you like that? Only the best. It's available somewhere. And I say that because I have a version. I went to go try to download a newer version, and I had no success. So I just stuck with the version that I have. But it's out there. It's got to be somewhere. So going across the top, it states what firmware you loaded up. So you can see on my desktop, I loaded up the Walking Dead 1.56 LE bin file, which you can download directly from the Stern website. Actually, you can't get the 1.56 anymore, but you can get the 1.60, which we will load up here shortly. Yeah. Hey-oh. What do we got there? That is something I can't see. Life Forcer, thank you for the host. Let's shrink that down just a little bit. I'm actually sitting at a computer right now, which makes it so much easier to do these types of things. All right. So first things first, up at the top it tells you that. That's where you go ahead and open your file. Over to the right, this is where you'll end up saving your file once you're done making any alterations or changes you're looking to do. So here's your different menu chunks right here. And please excuse any of my non-technical talk here. But the first thing it'll show you is display information. And this is basically showing you what your DMD would display. And if you were to scroll through here, you've got all kinds of things here. Walking Dead logo. Honestly, I don't know a whole lot about this because I haven't really done much with it. So here's stuff that has to do with the Well Walker. And there's a play button over here, and you can see it's kind of running through some of the animations. So basically, what it's doing is it's, and you can step through individually, you can grab this and just go nuts and just kind of go to whatever you want to see. There we go, there's a sword. And basically, these are just a bunch of images that are saved, and it's just running through the images. So, if you were so compelled, you could potentially go to an individual image. You can see it stepping through. And you could change the color of it with the drop down here. There's even something in here for Smart DMD. I don't even know what that is. We'll just avoid that altogether. Go back to red. We could go ahead and make changes to it. And what you can't see right now, and actually here's where it gets a little funky, because some of these editing bits, it pops open a new window and you can't see that. So what I'm going to try to do here is do a little of this. I'll have to do it on the fly so that we can make some of these pop up. So it creates this little edit image window here. And if I were so inclined, I could go in and start to make changes to this. Now, I am no artist, but if I start clicking in here, I can just say, oh, I want this particular thing to have black dots right in the middle. Because that's what I like. I like those to be right there. I could do that. I want to draw a circle. Circles are great. We got them. More circles, more squares. Lines, got those too. So, say that's not enough fencing, you want a window, boom, windows. His eyes aren't big enough. We can make them bigger. We can go bigger. Whatever you need. Boom. Now he's a zombie sugar glider. Anything you want. Within obviously whatever limitations are going on here. And if you need to see it bigger, well, for that fine tune, you can do that as well. If you were so inclined to turn him into a lion, I suppose one could do that. Some of the stuff, honestly, I've never messed with the edit image functionality. Grid. I guess if you want to go to the pixel, you can do that. Effects, apparently it just looks like it just slobbers it with a bunch of grease. I have no idea what that is. Fair enough. Say you don't like those changes you made, well, we can just undo them to an extent. These are staying because I apparently really like those. Properties, it pops open another window. Yeah, we're going to discard an exit, or you save and edit, save and exit, or you can save and go to the next image in case you were actually trying to edit a bunch of them and change the way something looked. You could do that. So we're going to discard an exit. You're about to close without saving. Yes. All right, so we close that out. That's fine. Yeah, exactly. Everybody needs a grease button. Hey, Voof. Thank you for the host. All right. So there you go. That's what you can do with display. I've never really done much with it, to be perfectly honest. It's one way to kind of go in and take a look at some animations that you may have never seen. Never again, like this. I don't even know what that was. I mean, I can see, I know, unless this is from Terminus, I know this is. I don't know what that is. I don't recall that. Apparently, we're in the logo section. and you know, play. But there you go. This is an option that you can go in and edit some of the individual things going on here. So that's one function, that's display. The main one that I've played with, and which most people have played with, is sounds. And that's the one we're going to spend the most time in. So I'm going to kind of just say, here's the sound section here, and then we'll move on, because we'll come back to that. The next one is messages. Any of the stuff that's displayed, I guess, here are all the messages. Honestly, this is another thing I've never messed with. I probably wouldn't necessarily say I would mess with it. I'm assuming I could probably go in here and edit something, and maybe this appears somewhere in the game, and it basically goes and calls this message off of these ID numbers. And if I were to go and edit that, there's a set... Oh, actually, you can't see it, so let's bring that up. It'll pop up this little menu here. And you can change what the message text says. So switch text or test. It has to be 11 characters or max. So switch Rudy. Boom. Modify this instance only. This message is used 2 times. Or override max length. Use free memory. We're not going to mess with that. So now instead of saying switch test, it now says switch Rudy. This is where you would get rid of the say no to drugs, or say yes to Rudy, say yes to Lion Man, whatever your heart desires. As long as, see, here you go, here's another switch Rudy down here. So there you go, that's messages. All right, next one up is adjustments. So here's your basic base machine adjustments. Some of them are like your, and you set a lot of these in your options. So say you want to have it preset to a certain setup. This is, you want to set your code so it's always has your Grand Champ high scores or whatever. Or maybe you are updating your code, or you have to redo your code and you want to keep your high score. Well, this would be a place where you could potentially, actually not here, probably under high scores to be honest, but this would be a place where you would go edit some of that stuff to create a default setup for how you want the code to be. These are all your basic adjustments from the game. So your pop-up or difficulty, combos for multi-kills, all that stuff. So minimum, maximum, and increment of 1. I've never really messed with these. To be honest, I would just change them from the in-game menu. Exactly. You can do it without changing the ROM code. But it's there because it's just showing you everything that's within the ROM code itself. All right, moving on. Next is high scores. This would be one where you could maintain and keep your high scores and put them back in. Say if you were playing around with a bunch of sound code edits and you wanted to get back to your original scores. Well, whenever you update code, it's going to wipe out all your old scores. And here's a way to kind of keep them. So if you were to go in and enter some of this stuff in, you would be able to put your scores back in. That way you wouldn't have to lose them. David DeTurk. Yes. Walker Kill Champion. Sam... don't know what this is. Never messed with it before, and we're going to keep it at that. Macros. I've never messed with anything here. And we'll keep it at that. Switch Rudy. Smart DMD. I'm guessing this is just a add-on collaboration between the guy who created Pinball Browser and the Smart DMD people. And config. Check for an update on startup. Check for bookmarks. Yada, yada, yada. Not much to say about config. So to be honest, those are your main things. So let's get back to the bread and butter here and why we're doing this, which is to show off the sound edit. So one thing that does happen when you boot up or load in an initial code is that it will ask you, would you like to check for bookmarks? And for some sets of code out there, people have already gone through and edited the sounds in a lot of these. And Walking Dead is a very popular machine that has been edited multiple times. Well, one thing that you may notice here is there's a lot of sound files in this game. I can click on any of them, go over here, hit the play button.
Shit, this is fun.
I didn't know what I was going to get, but there you go. And so you can click on any of these. Some of them are going to sound very the same.
That's the biggest bunch of them I ever seen.
Some are just, well, sounds. And the key is, with there being so many, how do you know what are the ones that you want to edit? Like, and how do you know which ones are actually being used?
We are all getting out of here.
I can go through this, and there's no real identifiers otherwise.
Let's get the hell out of here now!
Like, but you might remember hearing some of these while playing. So, how's it going, Einstein Way? So those of you who might be coming in and not sure what is actually going on here right now, let me open this back up. I am going through and showing off the Pinball Browser and how it works, and showing it off for Walking Dead. Walking Dead being Pinball Machine, and just going through and showing how I went through and edited sounds when I did the sound edit I did that one time. So, that being said, let's get back to where we were there. Pinball Browsers. Open. All right. So the nice thing is, for some of these that have been bookmarked, if I scroll up, what you're going to see is people have gone through and bookmarked a couple of these things. Oh, like for instance, here's one that says match. To say this is the sound that's used when the match animation's going on. So if I wanted a different sound during the match animation, that's the one I'd change. Up at the top, and this right now is sorted by length of track. Up at the top, you'll see a lot of these are called out, and a lot of these are familiar, whether it's riot mode. Hey, Juice, how's it going, man? So this is not virtual pinball. This is Pinball Browser, which lets you take the code file that gets uploaded or downloaded into Stern Pinball Machines and lets you kind of take a look and be able to visually see and hear all the aspects of that main bin file. And it separates out all the visuals and all the sounds, and even allows you the ability to replace and edit it if you'd like to. And that's what we're showing off here. So, the one thing you'll see here is a couple of these have been called out. And this is extremely helpful in the sense of, hey, if I want to replace what sound happens during barn, here's the original one. And it lasts for 56 seconds and 888 milliseconds. Okay, so the other kicker is these sound lengths are not changeable, not editable. They have to stay exactly the same. So whatever you replace it with is going to be that exact same length of sound. So, for instance, a lot of people have edited their Metallica machines to, when you say the images, are you talking about these guys here? So, here's all the images from the DMD, if that's what you're referring to. The answer to that question is yes. But right now we're focuses on the sounds. So the kicker is it's looking for that length of sound, which for Metallica, all of these, if I were to load up a Metallica one, you would see the length of the track there. But when you replace it, you're only going to get the length of what the audio track is that you're uploading. So say you want to replace one Metallica song that's longer than the song you're going to use. Well, you might have this blank, just dead space at the end, or if it's too long, it might just cut off early. So something to consider. But under most circumstances, the way that pinball sounds work, you don't usually hear through the whole thing. A lot of times it gets interrupted by another sound cue or something like that. Hey, Major Haskins, how's it going? Right now we're looking at a program called Pinball Browser, which is used to view and edit the sounds and visuals on real pinball machines by taking the code and it that you load into the machine, and this will allow you to visually check that out. I have really only changed out, well, I have a different sound package on Tron, and I've messed around with Walking Dead. I've never played with any of the other ones, to be honest. And I'm kind of just happy with the way that they are. I've never felt the need to have to change out any of the other ones. Although the idea of doing it is fun to do. I like the idea of doing Walking Dead because you can make it contrast the actual machine so much that it just makes it ridiculous. So now I've talked about that a whole bunch. Let's show off the changing out aspect. Browser. Yeah, that's, I mean, there's, what you can't see is that it's, I'm glad that somebody caught that. I was just testing you. Hey, Fishhawk, the only way I can point you to that sound pack is for you to personal message me. It's not something that's available out there publicly, but I do have a copy of it. So if you get in touch with me, I can like post a copy of it somewhere for you to get. So, not a problem there. All right. This was also a way for me to actually load up my Tron music and see what the differences were. Hey, Major Haskins. So tonight I'm actually doing a little bit of a tech stream versus playing live pinball. I've had a request at least once to show off this program called Pinball Browser, which is what we're looking at right now, which is what you're looking at over here. And it's a software program that'll let you you can download code updates for pinball machines. So say you want to update a pinball machine, they will update the game rules and codes and sound effects over time, and those files are freely available online, and you download them using a USB thumb drive to put them into a machine and upload them and get new code and rules. But this will let you take that same file and take a look at what all the sound files are inside of it, what all the visuals are on the display, and you can go in and edit all of this stuff as well as visually look at it. So that's what we're checking out here tonight. Hey, Mac Jedi. My pleasure, man. I'm glad to just taking a chance here to show this off, figuring at some point it would be helpful for somebody. I am by far and away not a pro at all at this. I just kind of played around with it. So let's get to the meat here. So say, for instance, we got this barn theme, right? This is great and all, but we want it to be different. So simply enough, you go over here and you have options, import, export, adjust volume. And the little bit of this is, and you can actually see that, it doesn't show it, but we're going to click import, and it's going to pop open a window, and all you do from here is you go ahead and you go select a sound file. MP3s work perfectly well, So say for instance you go to your favorite stash of MP3s. I've got a folder called Tracks for the Walking Dead, and we're just going to go ahead and open this sound file. And I'm going to go ahead and show you guys this window here. There we go. So now you can see the same window I'm working with. So there's the edit sound window once you've opened that up. And from here, it's actually kind of nice. It opens the sound file in its entirety. Actually, you know what? I don't want to do it that way. That's not that bad. Well, let me close this. We're going to do it differently. Import. And I'm going to actually, I've got the full sound files and I've got edited ones for simplicity's sake. I'm going to open the original full sound file just so you can see what that looks like. So, okay, here's the full sound file. And what you'll notice here is that particular track, and I'll move this, was 56 seconds long. So notice that it actually has the little push pins showing you that length. So what we're going to do now is, and this is pretty straightforward, you hit play and you can listen to the track itself. So here's the track we would replace it with. And say you just. This. And say you want to find that one point where you want to start. So that way, when that music kicks in, this is where it's going to start at. So you would just click the button to shift it to whatever position you want. So you want to find that one spot where you want to have that 56 seconds. And it's going to be right about here. Welcome back, Major Haskins. So you can see the length of it over here playing through that area. And it gives you an idea of how loud it is as well, which is nice. And we'll get into that later. So you also have a volume slider down here, which isn't going to show an effect right now, but I will tell you from experience that you're going to want to increase the volume to about like 250 to 300%. All right, so I'm going to stop that for now. So I'm going to increase the volume to about 250%, and actually I can hit preview edited sound. And it's actually going to play just that section at the volume change. So if I change that down, you can hear it's a lot quieter. But the reason we're turning it up is when you actually end up importing this sound, it's actually going to be super. All right, that's enough of that. It's going to be super quiet compared to everything else going on in the game. So I found myself having to go and re-edit my sounds over and over again after I uploaded it to the game when I realized, man, that's still too quiet. So I had to keep coming back and I kept increasing the volume and then having to resave the file and then re-upload it. The kicker is if you've never done a file upload on one of the SAM style Stern pinball machines, it takes a good like 40 minutes or so in order for that file to finish uploading. So to go ahead and load that in there, find out that the audio is just a little too quiet on a particular track, go back and heyo, Major Haskins, thank you for the burgly bits, man. Fill in the cup. It's kind of like a kick in the pants just because you're just totally wasting a bunch of time to just try it again. So I'm just telling you right now, volume, increase it to about 300%. And then all you do is hit import edited sound right here, and that's it. It's going to reset everything, and now it's in there. I go ahead, if I go to this and I hit play, Barn is now a cat party. Hey, CNK. Alright. We are checking out Walking Dead. So, well, Walker mode. So, something that I'd recommend, and I did this, let's see if this, can I get this to come up? This is probably a bad idea for me to try to do this on the fly, but let's see what we get. I've got another window. That is not going to show up. That's fine. All right. So basically what I have is in a Excel file, I went through and I pulled out, all the specific script numbers here on the left. Let me bring that back up. I pulled all the script numbers and labeled what they are. And I then went through and labeled what I wanted to change them to. So, for instance, let's find tunnel. I've got tunnel listed as 0x28, 48 seconds long. Here it is. It's not even labeled. And, yep, I'm editing 156 because 156, and I'm going to show this off. 156 actually has all these bookmarks in it. 1.6 does not have the bookmarks. So I'm just doing it this way so you can see the bookmarks first, before we go to 1.6. So here's Tunnel, which isn't even bookmarked. And I had that to be changed to something like this. Let's go import. And if I go back, I wanted this to be, where is it? Apparently, I don't even have it there. So we're just gonna put this in instead. Not a problem, Mac Jedi, not a problem. I'm not sure about that, Juice. So anyway, say I wanted to put this song in. But I can't really, Okay, so we can grab it there. We'll turn that up to 300-ish and import the track. And then boom, next thing you know, that one's in there too. So now you've got this. And this isn't even a track that I don't even... Here's a track I don't even honestly know where it's used. And then, is this in a hot mess of... Okay, so there you go. There's that. Sorry about that. Cat Party's still under barn. So this is where you basically go in and you can play around with all of them. But it helps that you can see some of these markups. And then it helps if you make yourself a kind of list so that you know what you want stuff to be and figure that stuff out before you get started. The other cool thing is you'll actually come across some tracks that you may not realize are actually in the game. There's plenty of stuff in here that never gets used, but it's here anyway. And maybe it's stuff that is used and I just have no idea where in the game it actually gets used. Hey, Flying Nun Killer, very nicely done. Very nicely done. There were no memos attacked. This was on-the-fly decision-making. So here, actually, this is a track that I stumbled on that, to me, sounds like it would be awesome for it to be in the game. And to be perfectly honest, I have no idea where this is used. This could be used as Last Man Standing, and I have no idea. But it's awesome. And then, so it's not necessarily just about that, but it's also about the sound effects too. I mean, all right, this game is a lot of that. I don't even know what that is.
Any man can shoot a gun, but a crossbow man is a special breed.
Like, I've never heard that call out before. $1.50 does suck per game, but it is a fun game to play. It is a fun game to play.
Any man can shoot a gun.
Anyway. But a lot of them you can see are also repeated numbers. Like that's the bombing from Horde mode, the super jackpot. So a lot of these are going to sound the same. So once you get to a different length, it might sound different. So anyway, you can go in and literally edit any and every single one of these.
Any man can use a gun, but a crossbow man is a...
So there you go. That is the general basics of editing. So now let's go ahead and load up. We've modified it. Do we want to save it? I'm going to say no, we don't want to save it. So now we're going to kind of get into it here a little bit. And actually, here's what I'm going to do a quick... I've got my code stuff. Here's my sound mod code for Tron. So we're just going to load this up real quick. And it's asking me, do you have any sound bookmarks for the firmware? Or I don't have any sound bookmarks for the firmware. Do you want to check online? I'll say yes. You don't have to edit all of them. I mean, when I edited maybe like 15 of the overall main sounds. You wouldn't want to edit all the sound effects. That would just be maddening. So here's Tron for the sake of it. So you can see mind-numbing logo stuff there. Stern logo. Oh, God. This isn't really working out that well. Flynn. There we go. So some light cycle action in there. Everybody's favorite stuff. Anyway, let's get to the sound. So this one has got a lot of edits on it, which is great. But in all honesty, without bringing up the original, I wouldn't know exactly what changes have been made here. So here's my Gem Multiball track. Here's a chance for you to hear call outs you might not. You might not normally hear.
For at this moment, the key to the next frontier is finally in our possession. And unlike our selfish creator, who preserved the privilege of our world only for himself.
And when I open my eyes, standing above me was the Creator. It became the symbol of something bigger, something better than this world.
So, there's clearly a lot of sound effects that don't necessarily make it into the game. Here's actually one of my favorite tracks, actually my favorite track, which is a replaced SOS music, which I like a whole lot. But yeah, you can see that this person went through and did a lot of work to actually call out what all of these callouts actually are as far as labeling them all, which is amazing.
Clue, Tron, and I, we built the system.
But have a drink, courtesy of the End of Line Club.
After the purge, I needed to reinvent myself.
So, anyway, and wow, this really, they went nuts. I don't think I ever really loaded this up and looked all the way down here.
Damn it. Sam, you did.
I'm Cora.
I was afraid you were going to say that.
So, clearly, there's a lot of callouts in this game. So, anyway, that's Tron. All right, moving along here. Sorry about that. Small sidetrack. Oh, and I've actually got a lot of other sound packages for Walking Dead. One of the most revered ones is the Cleland package. I'm just going to open that real quick just so you can see the amount of work that is in this one. He didn't change a lot of the musics, if you will, but what he changed was a lot of the verbal sound effects. And to be honest, I have no idea. Stuff that was pulled from the show.
But now we got the advantage.
Bicycle girl!
We're getting out of here, now!
But now we got the advantage.
So you can see that one there is one straight from Daryl.
You kill him or we'll be calling you Stumpy. Oh, you got the short end of the stick, boy.
Damn walkers have riot gear on.
So a lot of those are kind of left.
Zero tolerance for walkers.
The same, but there you go.
If there's one walker, we use our knives.
But there's a lot of stuff that's pulled from the show directly. To give it, since the original sound package does not have stuff directly from the show, fans of the game have gone back in and added their own.
Let me shoot. The gun will draw more of them.
Doesn't look like you're going to last very long in here.
But needless to say, when you're playing with this sound package, there's...
Oh, I knew you couldn't resist!
You clearly hear a lot of the new sound samples that they've added in. You could do that, Major Haskins. You could do Fraggle Rock. Or just make every sound the knocker sound, yeah. Whatever you would want your game to sound like. Alright, so now let's actually demonstrate for real now. So I'm loading up the 1.6 code. If I check for bookmarks, what I will find is there is nothing. So it's important that I actually know what it is I'm looking for. Let me see here real quick. So I'm not saying that it's real easy to... find and get songs or sounds if, say, you didn't have them. Let's see. But I bet if you used Google and you happen to, you know, try to find... something that would convert, I'm not going to say a YouTube video, but something similar to that, to a MP3, if you will. Where did that end up? Just one moment. So say I did that, put that there. Now if I go back, and let's say barn, right? So I go back to my little cheat sheet of stuff, since it helps to figure that stuff out beforehand. This one here I know is barn. So that's barn. So now we're going to go in and we're going to import. And we're going to go back to our sound packages. Just going to click on this new one here. Which looks like a hot mess. There we go. Jeez. And we'll hit play. We're gonna slowly move this thing over till we get... Actually, opening with that wind isn't bad. We'll make that 250. Hey, Holly Weird. That's for you, Rudy. Alright, so we'll stop that, and then we will import that sound, and now all of a sudden, boom, we are good. Now, one thing I'm actually not sure how to do is to add the bookmarks. That would be kind of cool if I figured out how to do that. Define bookmark. Well then. What if I did Barn Fraggle Rock? Does that do it? Hey, look at that. Now I've labeled it Barn Fraggle Rock. So, Holly Weird, good question. We have a team of pinball streamers, which the schedule is posted in the chat right now. And I myself am McSirTuna, the Saturday night streamer. Normally, I'm playing one of these pinball machines here each Saturday night. But this time around, I'm doing a little bit of a... I'm doing a little bit of a different tech stream here tonight, just to show off this specific program. So tonight is maybe not the best night to have stopped in for real pinball from me. But if the question... Holy crap. Now, some of that audio is coming through pretty bad. So we could re-fix that. But the real test would be what it sounds like when you actually upload it to the machine itself. Because to be honest, a lot of the sounds, like I mentioned before, come through a lot quieter than you anticipate. So there you go, Rudy Soup. That one was for you. So it's just as easy as, you know, I may not have had that track already, but I will just say that I, you know, maybe I own the Fraggle Rock soundtrack and I went and I grabbed that in the meantime. Because, you know, obviously you should only use the sound effects of what, you know, you own, of course. Anyway, make yourself a nice folder of sounds, and you can just simply plop in whatever you want. So there you go. It's that easy. Exactly, Miss Man 12. Exactly. And then I can take this bad boy and upload it right into my machine, and then when I'm streaming it, Blammo. Oh, there's another good one. Hold on. Let's do this one. Where was it? This was a good one. Where's the plunger? Here's where it's tricky. There's like a million of these things. So right now it's sorted by time frame. We could sort by script type. Here we go. That is not the sound I was looking for. I was looking for...
Oh, you are a mess.
Damn it. All right, let's do a different type of sort. So you can't add a sound, Triton. You can only swap out existing. But say you wanted to change a song. You can change the song and then go to the display, find the actual spot where it's showing that, and literally you can go in and edit it so that it shows the name of the song you want it to be. You could do that. That is be a little bit of work, but you can definitely do it. You can't add new though. You're only, this is meant to be a browser or viewer of the code, but it is allowing you to actually go in and chop out those bits. So, all right, damn it. Wait. That's not it, is it? That's still that noise. I did a terrible job of labeling. I've got OX18.
You are just plain out of luck. Guard tower! Guard tower! Bastard's gonna blow up the tower! Get in the bumpers and get some kills! I'll bet there's a bunch of walkers in that tunnel. Yeah, just follow them tracks into the tunnel. Let's go get some! Oh, now that's gotta hurt! Oh, now that's gotta hurt! Oh, you are a mess! Oh, you are a mess! Walkers, they're hungry. They're everywhere! They're everywhere! That steel ball should kill them! That steel ball should kill them! Shoot it! Shoot it! Shoot it!
Alright. Apparently it's not an 018. Apparently I was not good enough at labeling to know where that was located. Sweet move on my part. So I'm going to resort it. And yeah, Rudy Soup did an amazing job last night. In case anybody out there didn't catch that. Why did I not? Is it 18 seconds long? No? That's the ending of a ball. This might be it. Import, and we wanted to do where is it? No. There it is. I can't remember where. Yeah, just think, boom, right there. That's the kicker, Triton. That's the kicker. Is if you get in too deep, so you only get 10 seconds worth here. So we're going to save that. We're going to edit this to say plunge careless whisper. Thank you. Then there you go. You can hear that seemed a little quiet. So if you needed to, you could go back in and edit again. You can go back to import. Actually, can you edit? No, you can't. No, you can just hit adjust volume. So I can adjust the volume right from here. See that it sounds good enough. Save that. That's the kicker, though. If in a game like Metallica, you start to mess with stuff, it can play, since the names of the songs are tied to other modes and whatnot, it can mess with things. So you'd want to pick stuff to swap out that hopefully isn't as integrated, but it's always going to be a trade-off if you want to swap that type of stuff out. All right, so there you go. That is the kind of the quick-ish version of how Pinball Browser works up. Let's swap out a couple more songs here for kicks. Let's see. Riot mode, I did. That was 27. 45 seconds long. Knowing how long it is helps me when I sort it, because then it's easier to find, and then I can look at the script number to verify. So we'll go and import, and I'll just go right to that one's too short. Actually, just take the original version and we'll crop it in.
Now, last time you were here, you played a little piano for us. It was very nice of you to do that. Thank you so much. But you came on, and you played the piano, and we've been getting letters, emails, telegram, Western Unions.
What?
They said, if you get Jeff Goldblum in a room with Bismarck King, could you make that happen? And I go, I don't know. Now you're here, I was just wondering, could you make America happy?
Yes.
You can. I say that.
Let me tell you the story of my situation. I was talking to this girl from the U.S. nation. The way that I met her was on tour at a concert. She had long hair and a short
I probably won't be doing the edits, upload, and play all tonight. Simply because it does take like a solid 45 minutes to upload the audio. And if it's not perfect, we could be left with not a very good overall saved version of it. So it kind of takes a while to refine that and wouldn't necessarily make for the greatest stream, if you will. Hey, N Cheeks, how's it going?
She tried to pretend. She said, "No, I don't. I only have a friend."
All right, so we can stop that and we can import. And then we'll edit that. And that would have been the, that's Riot. Biz Goldblum. Save that in there. Boom, there you go. Hey, so yeah, and Cheeks, we're using Pinball Browser. I'm running version 6.00 right here. And as I mentioned earlier, you can download this from somewhere. There's a Pinside Forum link. If you do a search for Pinball Browser, you'll probably run across it. It's free-ish. It's free-ish to download and check out and look at stuff. But if you're actually going to start to really kind of get in and you wanted to do editing to it, you need to get a license for it to unlock the full potential of Pinball Browser. And basically what you do is you get in contact with the guy who made it. It was just one guy. He's on Pinside. If you send him a message, I think you just have to make him a donation. I don't remember exactly how much it was. And he'll send you a key. And then you have the ability, it'll be unlocked, and there you go, you'll have it in its full working capability. But you should be able to find it, download it, and just browse stuff with it. What's wrong with it?
It's talking to us.
So turn it off.
No, like, it's weird, just It's like spyware, graphic spyware has been detected.
Just hold the power button until it turns off.
It's scary, please.
All right, hold on, everybody. I will be right back. Sit back and enjoy some more of this. And I'm back. All right. Sorry about that. All right. Not in trouble. Don't you worry. There was some computer problems that needed some immediate attention. But problem is currently resolved as the computer just got turned off instead. So I will deal with that later. Anyway. Exactly, Rudy. Exactly. So if we go through, we can check out some more here. I think I've got we got main theme. That'd be OX1C. This one here. And this is gonna be, yeah, there you go. That one's familiar, right? And then we'll just upload this. Let's see here. You know, for whatever reason, I'm having trouble finding some of these old. I must have lost some of the original sounds that I had used. So we'll just put this one in there. That popped up. Good. So you can do this. Put this in there. Oh, oh, there we go. Alright, I'm not quite sure how this is gonna possibly turn into main theme. Seal. This can be a sound block stream in some regards, but the main content won't be. So, all right. So if we were to test that one, a little quiet, just volume. That's better. Saves it. Play. Boom. There you go. And say you wanted to finish this off. Say you were all done, you got all your sounds in just the way you like it, and you want to come over and finish it off. Well, let's do a save as, and it's just going to pop up a window for a save as. Save it to where you'd want. Stream edit. And I'll save that. And if I go to my pinball code, I now have where did I put that? I don't even know where I ended up putting that. That's because I put it in my soundtracks folder. Okay. So, boom, I've got a bin file that's for Walking Dead 1.6. And I would just take that file, put it onto a flash drive, and load it into the machine. Let it go through the 45 to 50 minute process of updating the code. And then, boom, there you go. Any of the changes you made, whether it's sounds, displays. Once again, for anybody who missed it, say you wanted to make a display edit. Let's see here. Let's find a good frame to edit. Oh, here's the one we edited before. Say, and you can go frame by frame. Rawr. That one right there. Say we want to edit that one. We're going to go into edit mode. And there we go. That's the edit window. And we can go ahead and make that a little bit bigger. Boom. So now we can really get in there. And we can go ahead and just darken that eye up a little bit. Say we want to get some tentacles coming off of his head. As most people don't know, zombies have tentacles. I'm also an artist, in case anybody out there needs help. I am here for you. Say he's got a little bit of an ear infection. And it's all puffed up. And you've got a bunch of different gradients there. There we go. There, that's pretty accurate. And then just, you know, you got to outline it. Make it look profesh. Fill that in. Boom. Oh, he's got an ear infection. That's terrible. Seal the deal. Nice. Hey, there you go. Triton with the Pinball Browser version 6.11 link. Boom. And yeah, hey, this guy needs a mustache. I don't blame you. Let's get him a mustache. Actually, we'll just go straight to the... There we go. He's a bit of a curly mustache guy. Real bushy eyebrows. He's letting himself go. And boom, there you go. Say that's good. We want to save it and go on to the next image. So now we just, you know, rinse and repeat. Here's the next image. Got to give him that big ear again. And bam. You've got yourself a hip antennaed walker for the ages. Whatever you need to do. And there you go. So if I wanted to, we'll save and exit there. So now, I mean, although it's in blazing speed, but you can see his awesome ear there. Unfortunately, I went with black on black background so that his antenna didn't show up very well. Oh, there's the mustache. That looks great. So, you know, he's casually walking out of his cage. Roar, roar, roar. Oh, I totally missed it. Roar. Oh, there it is. Roar. Roar. There he is. Roar. And back to normal. Boom. There you go. All the fun that can be had. My sounds, they are there. Fraggle Rock is the barn. Main theme, Seal.
It's a story of
my situation.
Riot.
I was talking to this girl.
Plunge with careless whisper. And then all the rest are still their original form. I still stand behind some of these are really cool, and I don't know where they're used. Like, there's another main theme one. This one, I'd love to see where this is used. I think maybe it's Last Man Standing, I don't know. So at this point, I guess I'll say, does anybody in the chat have any questions about Pinball Browser as it stands? Guessing if you wanted to change everything to a certain color, you could too. Oh god. Looks like an old LucasArts game of some sort. So in the past I did a big edit of 1.56 code where I put in a bunch of like really, really wonky songs that did not match anything at all. Exactly. Best way to get the high score. Exactly, Namus. I think this is just a tie-in for Smart DMD. Oh, you can't see the drop down. So yeah, there's Smart DMD there, which is I don't know how to whatever with that. So I don't know if that's just a means of you being able to play around for colorization purposes or what. But yeah, it's just something that's there. Oh, here we go. Changed it from an Alesing to 2X. Hey-o! Hey, Triton. Throwing them hogs. Ah, we still got half a hogs in there. Thank you so much, man, for the very generous bit donation. You, sir, are very kind. As I'm just letting these animations go on here. And this thing back on raw. Let's get back to that. And there you go, LEDs. 16x for that extra smooth look. Yes. Oh, the 2x. Very melty. I can see that. Classic orange. So there you go. That's the best I've got for a tutorial here on Pinball Browser. Hopefully this was helpful or interesting as far as how this goes. I spent my fair amount of time spent is honestly spent in figuring out what songs you want to put in. As soon as you get into the sounds part and then you click around and listen to all the sound effects and soundtracks, it doesn't take too long to find out which ones are the ones you're going to want to replace for what you want to do. But then it becomes a matter of, hey, let me go out there and find what song I want to replace it with, and then find one the section that makes the most sense within that song. So the part that sucks the most is when you're done and then you've uploaded it to your machine and then you realize the sound balance is off completely and some of it doesn't come through as loud as it needs to, and you have to go back and do it again, and it takes an hour until you can upload it. That part will drive you nuts, but the overall experience of creating all that stuff is a lot of fun. Go back to raw. Actually, LEDs get you back to a kind of more pixeled format here. I don't even remember that shooting animation. It's funny to see all these different animations that you may never really notice on the screen when it's the game's being played, or you may not actually see all of it, which is crazy. This is only for more recent model Sterns, yes. Pretty much anything, I would assume, where you can actually download the code for it. So I'd say Sam and newer-ish. I honestly am not entirely sure. I can't remember if it... I think it works with Spike, the 6.11. I'm not sure. Oh yeah, there's a lot of unused sounds for sure. And that is another cool thing, is to actually see all the unused sounds when you're going through it. So you can, even if you have no intention of simply doing any replacement work, you might find it interesting to download it for free and just browse through all the different sound effects in the game. I know that used to kind of be a big thing on Pinside a bit. Exactly. See all the unused sounds. I you know, as I say that, I was looking at some... there was a soundtrack for Secret of Mana on YouTube that I was utilizing earlier, and it was referencing the fact that it was in 1080p. So just alone, the soundtrack in 1080p was totally worth it. All right, so if there aren't any additional questions that anybody has, I think I'm watching animations from Last Man Standing there. Walking Dead does have some phenomenal DMD work. That is very true. Smell the adjustments. Nice. Really stacking those bodies up. I'm just sitting here watching the animations along with you. Blech. It's always interesting to see some of the stuff is actually done also in pieces. You can see how small the pieces are, and the pieces are just compiled together rather than it all being one cohesive single image as it stands, which makes total sense to do so that you don't have to redraw everything multiple times. It's crazy to see them in the different sizes too, in the different styles. Realizing they had to do every letter in each of the different sizes. Some of these things I don't necessarily even think about all the time when you're actually going through it. So, in lieu of, I don't know, do you guys, do we want to do, even though I don't really have a hedgehog halftime aspect going on here for tonight, since we're just showing this off, Do we want to have an early-ish hedgehog end time, if you will? Because I could still put on do some hedgehog action here. Import. Import. Oh. One other thing I didn't get to show is if the, sound is too short, they will automatically put a blank in at the end. There you go. If the sound is too short, then the original track you're replacing, it'll just be a big blank splodge at the end there. We'll upload that too. Why not? So there you go. And yeah, that's a good point, Namus. Is Run DMD, the clock that I have on the wall over there, has a lot of animations on it. A lot of those animations are not just Stern's, but also other ones. So, good old-fashioned flute work on the Jurassic Park theme there. Always a...
to Jurassic Park.
Oh, how's it going, Andy? All right, I'll just... All right, well, that being said, let me, I guess, kick it over and we'll do an early half/end time show here tonight. Hopefully you guys enjoyed some Pinball Browser action. Oh, jeez. And I guess I will be back in the... soon.